Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk about how can we support our children during puberty. Yes, there are some topics even in the modern era which is considered to be a taboo and we don't want to talk comfortably with our children. Topics like love marriage or sex or menstruation or wet dreams. So what happens is we parents don't want to or we are not much comfortable talking about these things to our children. But children are also very smart these days. What do? They try to learn from some external sources and these external sources are not from the reliable ones. Of course, because these may be through friends or some adults, they will just or maybe even browsing sometimes, they'll just go and learn something or in fact, they may be having much more advanced ideas as well. But what do we need to do? It is very important as parents to talk about puberty before they come and ask us. So don't wait for your child to come and ask you about these things. It is our responsibility to go and talk to them. This is how the changes come and we are able to connect very easily with our children. So let us be mindful about it and how can we help our children. Usually what happens is parents are not very certain about how to support or how can I be of little help to my child during this time, because this is a time of transition. This is a time where they have physical, psychological and also emotional changes that takes place in their body, right? And I certainly feel that this is the best time that a parent can get connected or can have that bonding between each other, because it is at this transition period the child feels disassociated or the child feels disconnected from other people and he feels connected only with his peers and friends. It means he has that urge or he needs somebody where he can share his dreams or where he can share his comfort or about his own feelings. And if we become that person, it is the best situation or it is the best for our children also to come closer to each other and have that very close bonding. Another reason is that we are having the first-hand experience of our own children and we know their identity and that experience what they have come across throughout their life so far. So we can treat them in a way that nobody else can do it. So now let us discuss how as parents we can help our children during this puberty stage. Number one is the best strategy that we have is to bring them reassurance and ensuring that the child is safe talking to you. Create an environment where the child feels very safe and he feels that, okay, I can talk to my father, I can talk to my mother in this regard, because this is the time where they are looking for somebody. They need that support, they are urging, they are craving for someone whom they can address their emotions to or their feelings to. So it's our duty to be that person. Let them create an environment of trust. Let them trust you. Let them come forward and express their feelings very freely. Second point is that a teen, whenever he is in his puberty level, usually he is much concerned about his external looks, about his the growth of the body parts or sometimes the facial hair, the growth spurts and many other things they are very much concerned about, and they feel awkward also sometimes. So it's our duty to make them feel that it's normal and everybody feels it, and it's a part of your growth. Once you grow up, your face looks really beautiful. That is how we are designed. So create a kind of a positive environment whenever he feels low or she feels low. And what happens is when they are not physically okay, I mean when they feel that their physical appearance is not good, they feel really low in their self-esteem and self-confidence. So this should not affect the child's self-confidence and identity as well. So it's our duty to see to it that whenever he is feeling low or she is feeling low about her body parts or her external body growth, we need to support them. We need to tell them it's okay, you really look beautiful, but instead of this, you can do this, you can try this. So give them some kind of recommendations, or you can use these facial creams, or you can use this soap, you look really beautiful. So all that things when you say, they feel that my mom or my dad is really concerned about my looks. So try to talk about these. They are very much concerned about acne, muscles, or sometimes even their height or their weight and all that. So tell them all these things are the parts of it's a part and parcel of life, and that's how we grow. So it's okay if you have these things. These are just the traits, and once you pass the stage, maybe you reach about 16 to 17 years of age, then everything will set right. So make them, give them that assurance. Third point is that we need to talk about their emotions. They are really concerned about all that things, the thoughts that come to their mind. Tell them that it's okay, it is something natural to have opposite genders, you know, you have that attraction and it's something normal. Talk to them about it. But how can we be mindful and set boundaries? These things also need to be explained. So we have to be in sync with their thoughts and tell them that yes, these things are common and everyone has that. But the thing is, how can you restrict yourself? What are the kinds of boundaries that you need to have in your life? Let us explain about that and try to give them more, try to give that maturity. The fourth point is that if you have a daughter, talk to her about menstruation. If you have a son, talk to him about wet dreams. This is very, very important. I know people are hesitant. We don't want to talk about this, but it is mandatory as a parent to talk about this in private so that the child is aware of it. I'm sure that the child may be having some other ideas also. They may be having some knowledge about this also, but there may be some myths also. So try to take out all that. What is the reality as per science? What is it? What to talk about the hygiene? So everything you need to talk about these things, because this matters a lot. We need to understand that when the child is able to know everything in detail from her own parent, the child reacts in a different way. The child's reaction is totally different and becomes positive. So let us know more about all these things and be approachable to our children. Lastly, very important point is the child may be considering you and he may trust you and she may ask certain things with you, maybe about his friend or her, about maybe the child's emotions or how he felt or he had thought about these things, or I had seen some videos, all that things. He may start telling some secrets, whatever is there within him. Never try to judge the person and taunt or start commenting something ill about the child's thoughts and the deeds what he has done. Never do that. If you start commenting, if you start telling something wrong about his emotions or whatever he has told to you as a secret, then he will never come to you talking about these things. Never try to do that. Try to be mindful. Do not judge the child. It was our fault that we didn't approach the child before the child was searching for it. Right? So we have to understand these points and set clear picture about puberty, what happens, why it is happening, what are the things we need to do. Let us discuss and talk about this and create some changes and have better environment at home. Hope you like this video. If you have anybody in your circle who is in need of these videos, try to share it with them and be of little help in their life also. Be a torchbearer in their life.